Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Welcome back to old times. I sold all those trees. I actually cut down one more and sold that one as well. I have returned the Pika Model 75, or equivalent of. I've bought some sheep. You can see up there, you got Mouton 100, and we now have 100 Poule. I think that's how you pronounce it. Chickens, anyway. So we have 100 chickens, and we have 100 sheep. The weekly question before we go any further: do you want me to use the Grimme Rootster and the FT300 topper for harvesting the sugar beet? I know that this is a more modern version, but I haven't been able to find a decent trailed one, so I think we can sort of just pretend that this one is a slightly older version. It's pretty much the same thing. They haven't really changed very much in design, so I think we could get away with that. But do you want me to use that one, or do you want me to use the RKS-4 by this one? Because obviously we can't hire this one. It won't come up. So I'd either have to buy that one or hire the Rootster for harvesting the sugar beet. Which one do you want me to use? It's your vote. It's your game. Head down below and let me know what you think. So we've got the 100 chickens. And oh, I'm actually up to 89 coins. I don't know what's going to happen when we get to 100 coins. Whether it's just going to crash because I keep picking up the same coins all the time. 60 eggs we've got here. And it went red at 50, but it's still been getting extra eggs here. So we've got 60. I don't know how many it would get before it stopped accumulating eggs. But I'm assuming that it's gone red, just because it's getting close to its absolute limit of eggs that it will hold. But there's 95 eggs in our backpack, which is pretty good. Now, we have sheep, so that means we're going to need to get them some grass. We've also got... I've finished the field over there. So the first thing that I'm going to do is get the fertilizer spinner, and I'm going to spread fertilizer on the field of canola that we spread, that we sowed. So let me just start this one up. And I got to remember where I put my fertilizer spinner. Where did I put the fertilizer spinner? It's not there. It's not in that one. Is it in one of these? No, that's the car and the combine. It must be over in this bit round here. So we've got all our sheep in the sheep paddock right there. And I'm going to buy a mower, and I'm going to buy... Right, I think it's actually in this one, isn't it? Ooh, don't drive into the trees, Frith. Where is my fertilizer spreader gone? I had a fertilizer spinner. Where did I put it? Is it in one of these? It's not there. It's not there. It's not there. Is it over in this corner? Oh, there it is. Right, I'm driving around in circles. Right, so we get the fertilizer spinner put on, and we'll load that one up, and we can start that one going in the field that we have sown. The issue that I've got is that the seed drill runs out really fast, and the next field that we've got to sow is actually, I think, it's our biggest field, or it is just about. Field 2 is one of the biggest fields. It's either 2 or 3 or 6 is the biggest ones, but anyway, yeah. It took long enough loading up field 5, or sowing field 5. I kept having stop, run back, get more seed, stop, run back, get more seed, and it took a very, very long time. So I'm actually thinking I will try and find a bigger seed drill that is appropriate, because the ones that we've got in the map, or the standard game ones, let's have a look at what we've got, sowing machines. We got this Pottinger, which that seems a little bit too modern, really. I suppose it might pass as an older machine, but I don't actually have a tractor that can pull that, and I don't have the money to spend on a new tractor for it at the moment. And then sewing machines here, I don't have very many. I got this old one. I got this Kuhn 3-meter, which is it's got 780 liters in it. This one here is 450, but it's an old Amazon one, which would be really nice, but it's actually classed as lizard, so I really don't want to use it. So I'm going to try and find that thing there. That's a beast. I won't be using that, though. That one, I'm not really sure what that's all about. That might be something to do with that one, actually. And then you got this one here, which is a All in one. Yeah, so that one seems... might be acceptable, I suppose. But again, I don't have a tractor that can pull it. I'd like something like that one, but I don't have it at the moment. So that's something I'm going to look into. So I'm not going to be doing any more sowing today. I will start filling this one up, and I will at least spread fertilizer on the field that we have just sown. That's the first thing that we're going to do. And then I'm going to break out the combine, and the combine is going to get started on the two little fields that we've got. They are ready to cut now. And then the only other thing that we've got ready to harvest at the moment is the sugar beet, which I'm possibly going to be doing next week, actually. It will be very soon. Now, I don't think I can drive on the bit down there without damaging the crop. Let me come out of cab for this and start up through. Why did it not start? I've got to lower it down. Oh, no. Why is it not starting? F1. Lower. And... why is it not allowing me to start the fertilizer spreader manually? That seems a little bit peculiar. I can do it like that, but it wouldn't allow me to hire it to just do it myself. I didn't even have the option to do it. I've never seen that before. Right, let's change that. I think I'm going to actually damage the crop if I drive on this. Oh no, second growth stage is all right. You can get away with second growth stage. Not really sure why it's not allowing me to spread the fertilizer myself. Something I will worry about another time, I think. We'll just set the hired help going. He can carry on. And we'll just have to keep an eye on him for when he empties out his fertilizer spinner. Right, next job. Get rid of that. I want to take the combine out. Combine is actually in... oh no, I can't access the door from that side. The combine is just around here. We've got the header just lying down there. We've got the trailers here ready. So let's get into this one and start up. And then as soon as we've got this one underway, because we've got auto combine now, the auto combine can just carry on and do its stuff, do its thing. And right, be careful that I don't hit that over there. Line this up correctly. Come back round there. Now turn sharp. There we go. And then come forward again. And there we go. Right. I'm getting the hang of this. Anyone would think that I was a professional. There we go. Let's take that one over. I'll drive this over to the field. And then I'll take the trailers over there so that they're ready to start offloading this one. And then... right, that one can just stay where he is. After that... yeah, we need to buy a mower, and I think we'll buy that forage wagon that we were using. Can I get through here or not? Don't think I can. Ooh, just. That's a bit of a squeeze, but still. That's all right, we're through. Right, I'll go and get this set up, and then we can get going with some mowing. I'm just backing this one into the shed here. Drop the seed drill in here under cover. Lower that one down. Climb off and disconnect. There we go. Right. Going to head over and get the mower. I've got the mower. We've got the rake there. That will be... we'll be able to use that one. And I've got the... I've bought a loading wagon as well. The forage wagon that we used last time. You remember the one that we used on the straw? I've got that one ready to go as well. So we'll go and get the mower and then I can get started. I'm going to mow that field right there. It's going to be our first port of call. There is our mower and our loading wagon. It's actually brilliant that we can now afford to buy some of these things. So the forestry work really has paid off, and we will do some more. Obviously, we're not going to do loads and loads of it because I think it's kind of almost a little bit game-breaking that you can make so much money doing it. But, I mean, forestry was a huge part of... right, I didn't want to do that. Lift it up. And fold that one back up out of the way. Forestry was a huge part of Scandinavia, at least. And there, you know, there's other areas, especially all over Europe, where forestry was quite a big part of their finances. And I don't quote me on this, I don't know for certain, but I think a lot of farmers did do forestry as well. Although I'm not sure, it might have just been that you had people who did forestry and you had people who did farming. So, yeah, I'm not entirely certain of that. Now, if we've got any options on this one, we can lower. Lower and lower. There we go. Right. And... right, why is it not letting me start? I've got a mod somewhere that's conflicting and it's not allowing me to actually use some of these tools now. I hope it's not auto combine that's doing that. But again, I can't use this one. I wonder why that is. Oh no, I don't have anything that's conflicting. I'm just being a little bit slow. I've got the PTO thing and I haven't actually joined the PTO. If I joined the PTO, I'd actually be able to do it. Now, let me just go and get this trailer a minute and we'll unload the combine as he's here waiting patiently. Or he will be in just a second. He comes down that far side there. Nip round here. And we'll probably actually be able to rake this up at the same time as rake up the other field. Now, is that going to stop or is that going to swing on round that corner? Oh, he's going to swing on round. That means he's probably going to stop just down there in a second. And hopefully we're not going to be in the way when we park alongside him right here so that we can unload him. Just go right there. Perfect. Right. Switch that tractor off. He can stay there. And now we can go back over here. So that's why I couldn't start the fertilizer spinner either, was because I forgot to put the PTO shaft on. And it does help if you do that. Right, there we go. Now it started. Let's mow this field. Now, I did test this mower before. And because of the dirt and... Dirt and terrain mod, I think it is, the one that causes the wheels to sink in the ploughed ground and causes the crops to get destroyed, that sort of thing. I did find that the mower bounces a little bit, which is a little bit sort of disconcerting, because if you go over a rough patch, it really does bounce a lot. Although this tractor is not going very fast, I put it on a bigger tractor, and because the bigger tractor would go at about 14 miles an hour, it really had the mower leaping up and down like a bucking bronco. It was absolutely awful. It's not the way that you want to treat your mowers. It really isn't. And right, that, oh, the combine is empty. That's the grain trailer. So the fertilizer spinner is actually empty and needs to be refilled. That's the one that that has stopped running. So we'll do a little bit more of this one. It's mowing quite nicely here. You can't complain about that. So normally the way that you would mow a field when you've got a side mounted mower is to just keep going round and round like this. And then the very final pass that you do on the field is the outside round. And the reason you do it like that is because you can cut all around the inside and usually you wouldn't have much trouble. If you were going to catch a stone or something that might break the mower, it would be on the outside round. So you do that last to ensure that you had at least cut the majority of the field before you completely obliterated your mower on that errant stone. Just a little bit of a mowing fact for you there. Usually though, if you were at all concerned that there might be stones lying around, you would do a walk around the field first, just around the edge, to make sure that there weren't any such stones lying around. I can remember several times going into a field and then having to walk the perimeter, especially if it was just a fence, it'd be fine, I could just carry on. But if it was a stone wall or a stone hedge, I would walk up and down that hedgerow just to make sure that no stones had rolled out or been knocked out by any sheep or cattle or anything while it wasn't actually being used. And I did that hours and hours I actually spent walking around fields making sure that there were no stones there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to continue around this field until I have mown the whole thing. So we've seen it, and then I will come back to you for the final outside round. In the meantime, I will also go and fill up that fertilizer spinner and set that one going again and just make sure that that combine is working as he should be. Well, the fertilizer has finished, and the combine has finished that little field over there, and he's now working on his first, or just about finished his first round on the next field over. I have just got this little bit in the middle, and then the outside round, and we can start raking up. But we are actually running out of time, so I don't think we're going to get all of it done today. So what I will do is I will finish up this mowing, and then, as we've seen the rake being used quite a lot, I'll rake this field up, ready for gathering up and feeding to the sheep in the next episode. The other thing that we should, you should note, I'm going to tell you, is that I don't particularly like this mower. It works just fine as a mower. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just, it's rather small, and so it takes quite a long time to cut anything, which is kind of what you'd expect for something this old. However, we are allowed things right up to 1980. So the time has come, I think, to very soon invest in a bigger tractor. We did use the Kirovets Russian tractor, which is good for things like ploughing and that, but I don't want that as a runaround tractor because it's too big, too cumbersome. I don't particularly like it. So I'm going to have a look around for a new tractor that we can use. We may even do a little bit more forestry so that we can afford to buy this tractor that I want to get. Not quite sure yet. I don't really know how things are going to pan out with that. But then I'm going to have a look around for a bigger mower. And most mowers up until 1980 were side-mounted, and generally they would have been drum mowers. And you just quickly see how big this one is. And where are we? Mowers. There we go. Right, this one here has a working width of 2 meters. This one here, which is a side-mounted one, John Deere, I think is actually mid-90s that one's from. It's a trailed one. I think that's about 3.5 meters. We don't really have anything there, but if you have a look back here in the standard game, this one here, this Pottinger, this is a 3-meter working width, and this is actually pretty similar to ones that have been used for a very long time. I think this is actually a bar of several cutters rather than a drum mower, which consists of 2 great big drums and a few knives around on each side. But it's pretty much the same thing. So that one could actually pass as a 1970s mower. I know that particular model isn't precisely a 1970s model, but I will have a hunt around and see if I can find another one. Because something a little bigger than this 2-meter one would be perfect. And it also mean if we had a bigger tractor, we'd be able to go a little bit faster as well, because you're able to go quite a bit more than just 7 miles an hour when you're doing some mowing. Mowing is quite a speedy task, actually. You can really motor through it. And, right, just get that last little bit there, one little strip, and then we can just do one pass around the outside. Hopefully we don't meet any stones that annihilate our new mower, because that's the last thing we want. And then we're done. So while we're doing this outside round, remember the weekly question: do you want me to use the Grimme Rootster, which is the trailed sugar beet harvester, which is this one, and the topper to go with it? I know that they're not pre-80s models, but they're very, very similar to ones that we use pre-80s, so I think that would be okay. So do you want me to hire the Grimme, or do you want me to buy the older RKS-4 harvester? It's your vote, it's your game. Which one do you want me to use? You've already seen that one being used, sort of the potato version. It's very, very similar. I think about the only difference is that it's sugar beet and it's red. So yeah, decide which one you want, head down to the comment section down below and let me know. Tell me all about it. How is that combine doing? He stopped. But I'll tell you what, let me just leap off this tractor. He could just stop there a minute, as I'm quite close by. It's because this tractor is close and it doesn't like it. It's trying to turn in a loop by the look of it. So let me move back here and start it again. It should. There we go. You move back in and he'll grab a hold of it. Right, that one will carry on. And I can just finish off this outside round. Don't step on the mower. That's the last thing you want to do, is step in front of that mower. Because those teeth, they might not look like much, but they are vicious, and they will take your leg right off. If they could, they would take your leg right off. But luckily those teeth, I don't think a man's leg would actually fit in between those teeth. You could certainly take your hand off. Ooh, I'm buzzing. That means I have run out of time. So we've got our forage wagon that we'll be using in our next episode. Let me just come into cab just this last little bit so we can sort of see it. You can't see the mower from the cab. It's just out of range, which I don't like, so I'll just do it like this. Close enough. There we go. So yes, if you've enjoyed this episode, then please head down below and give us a like. And if you really enjoyed it, please tell your friends all about me. Get them to watch as well. That would be awesome. Next time, I will be picking all of this up. I'll have it all raked and ready. I will pick it all up in our next episode, and we will feed it to the sheep. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.